Transmission begins.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. This is the Josh Tolley Show on the GCN Radio Network.
All right, we're going to do things a little bit different this morning. You already know who I am. We're going to forego all the normal introduction stuff because I really want to get to our guest because we're on a truncated timetable here. Last week, we told you about a story where a young man was taken into custody and sent to a psychological hospital because of comments he made on Facebook, and his mother joined us on the show. And his mother, Cathleen Thomas, is back with us again today to give us an update. Cathleen, welcome back to the show. How are you doing, ma'am?
I'm doing well, thank you.
So, obviously, everybody's going to want to know the first question. How is your son doing?
Yeah, well, thank you, first of all, for just your partnership and getting the story out. I just want to give huge kudos to you and there's many others there that have, you know, just stepped up to the plate and reached out to us. So thank you profoundly and profusely for that, for freedom. That's what this is all about. My son is doing very well. He is in good spirits. We are able to visit him. He is not being drugged. He can refuse any medication. But he has had his hearing yesterday. I think most of America knows that. And he has been continued to be detained in the same institution that he's at. It's a psychiatric ward.
Now, that raises a bunch of questions, and I know there are some legality issues, you know, things you can and cannot say, and I completely understand that. But one of the things that kept popping up for listeners after the show, and we kept getting emails, was the fact that even if there were comments on Facebook that people wouldn't find friendly, what was it about Brandon that brought this attention? Because there are so many of us that would be found guilty of the same thing that I really think that his situation has sent a shockwave across America. Was there anything that we're missing here, Cathleen? Because everybody said, Josh, there has to be something else. There has to be something missing here.
Yeah, I appreciate that. To the best of my knowledge, not yet. Nothing that I know of. My son and I are very close. We have very candid, open conversations. And, you know, I've asked him, you know, why do you think that you were targeted? And he said, I do not know. We do not know. That really just do not know. And that is where we're at right now. A huge shout out to the Rutherford Institute. John Whitehead, his wife Misha Whitehead, you know, I can't thank them enough. They've run to our aid very rapidly and said, you know, we will support you. They had their lawyers down there at the hearing. I mean, they drove all the way over. Did a very professional job, represented us as best as they could. But, you know, we're scratching our heads. We now have a local lawyer working on the case with us. And again, you're right, there's only so much I can say. We're just not sure. We're trying to get answers and details. And really, there's been a lot of just vagueness in this whole situation. One hand not speaking to the other, meaning the FBI's hand really not speaking to Chesapeake County Police's hand and vice versa. We're just trying to figure out, you know, really why he was detained. We were told it was a civil matter. It was a temporary detention order from Chesterfield County that the magistrate placed due to him possibly being mentally unstable and not fit for society, meaning he could harm himself or someone else based on his Facebook post. That's where we're at. That's all we know. And, you know, as I said, the lawyers are trying to tear open this book and figure out the story. And, of course, we will share as soon as, you know, we know more. But I do want to say that you can certainly keep in touch with news updates. You know, the Rutherford Institute invites you phone calls. If you have any questions, they are your direct contact. And I can give you that number and name if you'd like it, you know, before I sign off here.
Well, actually, I'll give it after your sign off because we're on for another 2 hours. I want to make the most out of our time with you, but I'll definitely get that out to people because I have that as well.
Okay, thank you.
Now, one of the things that found its way to the top of this news story was the involvement of these other agencies. Even if there was a case where the county and local officials thought, okay, there might be something wrong with an individual and there might be some merit to that sort of execution of a detainment, the weird thing here is the involvement of Secret Service and FBI and other organizations that have kind of got their hands in the pot. Usually when we see this sort of thing, Cathleen, it's followed by or even led by some sort of media PR blitz that, hey, the FBI saved the world because we caught a potential terrorist. And they've been kind of quiet on this one. Is there any indication as to why that is, or are there cards that they're still holding back?
I do not know the answer to that. I really don't. I have no idea why the FBI or Secret Service were there. We've not been told, except when I did speak to, which I've also shared before, I spoke to Agent Sherry Granger. She called me and she said, you know, the FBI has come to your house due to Facebook posts. That's what I was told by her. And Chesapeake County has placed him under arrest due to resisting arrest and assaulting an officer, which we found out later he actually was never arrested for that. It's just been a real, it's been a real game. We just do not have any clear, forthright answers. And that's the most frustrating piece. But I know that our lawyers are working hard and some answers will come. And as they come, like I said, we will share them. But to answer your question, I have no idea why the FBI was involved. I really don't.
Well, and one of the things that has a lot of people concerned, Cathleen, is, like I stated before, so many other people would be guilty of this. Because what your son did was he posted song lyrics. Now, I was listening to a song on the way into the studio today that said, I hope your brakes go out going down a hill. I hope a flower pot falls from a windowsill and knocks you in the head like I'd like to. Now, if I posted that on Facebook, would I then be considered harmful to myself and others just because I posted song lyrics?
I don't know. You know, I do get that. I'm a staunch patriot. My daughter, my other son, we have other members of the family, where as we've sat around our kitchen table and opened up books and done some real reading and thank God for the people that have gone before us that, you know, really risked their lives to get information out, whistleblowers and whatnot. You know, we've all posted things like this. We're all pretty much, you know, just frustrated with some of the things that we're seeing in our country that are completely unconstitutional. And you know, still 9/11 is up in the air. How do we, what do we know about that? And just questions. And we're called by the First Amendment to question our government, to come before them, it says, with a regress of grievances, basically, you know, to put our pulse on them and to ask them these questions and to hold them accountable. So we're all doing that. Yes, you're right. I don't know why Brandon was targeted at this point. So.
Well, I don't either, because even if you take some of the more, let's just call them stronger posts, and there were stronger posts, but we've all had them, and that would be the same as saying, well, if Barack Obama says he's going to take aim at Mitt Romney this November, does he really mean take aim and grab a gun? Or I mean, there's so much open to interpretation here. If I said, well, I'm gunning for Rush Limbaugh's number one spot in radio, does that mean I'm going to go get a gun and go after Rush? Of course not. So the part that confuses me, and I'm really looking for some answers here, is why Brandon? I mean, there's millions of people who post on Brandon's wall, who share Brandon's posts, who share similar stories and updates. I'm just, there's a disconnect here that I really want to fill as to why it's Brandon.
Right. Want those answers too. Yeah, and may, you know, it could be that there's something else that I'm not aware of. I do not know. All I can say is I've spoke openly and candidly with my son. You know, he's been very, very vocal, maybe more vocal than some, of trying to hold our Congress, our senators, our government accountable. And you know, we have every right. We're told in the Constitution that if, you know, our governing authorities are not following the Constitution, we have every right to go and raise our voices and hold them accountable and remove them, actually. The language is so strong that we can remove them and petition.
And not only is it a right, it's our duty.
It's our duty. Yes, sir. You got it. Yep. And that's the part right there, Brandon. Yeah. He feels it's his duty as a patriot. Yeah.
And I think a very interesting thing to point out here is recently he did an interview himself where he pointed out that he was even thinking about re-enlisting into the Marine Corps. So this was not some sort of un-American sort of, you know, that they like to paint a picture of a guy who's living in the woods and has 50 cats. And that's not the situation. And ma'am, I thank you for being with us. I know you have to run. But save any information that we might not know about yet, this seems to be a case that might backfire on the powers that be, because it's a wake-up call for millions of us. So thank you, and I'll be praying for you and your family. We'll be back right after this.